Hello there. As we are nearing the end of the year, I thought it was time for a highlight video from all the amazing hiking and backpacking trips I've been on in 2020. I also want to extend a heartfelt thanks to all the people that have invited me on trips through this year. Chuck and Matt, Joey, Catherine and Kristen, Russ and Kelsey, and anyone else that I might have crossed paths with in this past year. 2020 has been a weird year for a lot of people, and also for me, you know, with the corona and everything, made all the previous plans just be put on hold, but it's still been a great outdoors year for me. A lot of the things that got canceled gave me more time to spend time in the wilderness and being out for extended periods of time, which made this one of my best backpacking and hiking years ever. So I've decided to split this highlights video in two. Part one will cover the first half of the year, and then part two, that will be out around Christmas, will cover the second half of the year. Enjoy the video and have a great holiday, and I'll see you next year.
must be nice to call everywhere home, everywhere you go. It's been a while since I felt like I belonged inside my soul. Keep up with all of my worries, I gather in flowers, I've run out of hands. Slow down my mind, it gets blurry, I'm ready to feel something freeing again. That I wasn't ready, now I think it's time to let go of all of my worries. Like gathering flowers, they fall from my hands. Slow down my mind, it gets blurry, I'm ready to feel something freeing again. you say I'm a gem, 'cause I'm so precious. You keep me real close to your skin, and I like it. You say I'm a gem, well honey I'm rough around the edges. I don't let anybody in, I always fight it. I got a diamond mine. I was never looking for somebody if I'm telling the truth. Somebody's gonna be you. Setting off explosives in my brain. All of my emotions echoing. I don't want nobody unless that somebody's gonna be you. In my diamond where the other side saw darkness. Dig a little deeper, love, I know we both want this. Never judge a mountain or a woman by its cover, 'cause you might find your legacy when you get to know her and her diamond. her diamond. Somebody's gonna be you. Setting off explosives in my brain. All of my emotions echoing. I don't want nobody unless that somebody's gonna be you. In my diamond mind.
is all that green stuff you got? Is that backpacking food?
Got bringing in 7 avocados. Maybe only 6. I might eat one in the morning. Got a bunch of jalapenos. It's good food, nutrition. Oh, yeah.
Really cool. So anything that could break on this trip, you bringing for food?
Bringing eggs. So just gonna keep them on the top of the pack. They should be good. Bringing a lot of stuff. Got garlic, shallots, I already say that. Brats. Sriracha.
Okay, so all your typical backpacking foods.
Well, it's good food. Yep. More about nutrition, you know. I'm like, yep. I don't, doing a lot of trips lately, so I don't have an opportunity to eat very healthy. So I'm trying to get in my veggies. I can. This is kind of a easier paced trip.
Cool. What kind of trip are we doing, actually?
We're going to go down Death Hollow. Actually, we're going to go from Hell's Backbone. We're going to go all the way down Death Hollow to the Escalante River. And then we're going to come all the way up the Slick Rock Saddle Bench to Sand Creek. And then kind of walk a ridge back to the Hell's Backbone Road. Do with pretty excited to be doing this. This is one of my favorite canyons. Very beautiful canyon, a lot of nice narrows. Just a very unique landscape. Quite a few sections of the canyon have what we call swimming holes. They have water through them where it's above our head. It's gonna be cold water, might not be a lot of sun. So we're bringing rafts and tubes for this to kind of float our packs through and stay dry. And I mean, basically this is like an obstacle course and we're just gonna play the course, see what it's like, and work our way through it. We're planning on taking 7 days, 6 nights to do the trip. Could probably do it a little quicker, but we want to take some time and explore some areas along the way. So should be an interesting and exciting trip. If you're going to go play a round of golf, where do you want to go play? And you want to go play your favorite, you know, course. That's what we're doing right now. About to go play my favorite course with my buddy Yaro, who already has a passion for this stuff. This happens like every 15 minutes to each of us. So it's like constantly every 6 or 7 minutes, you know. Then it's like you're in pain, you know, like you're in pain while these needles are in you. It's all good though. It's all good. We're here. We're in Death Hollow.
We got your camp, Joey.
It's camp.
Yep.
And we saw a bear right here at camp.
We did. That's going to be an exciting night. So here's my tent and Joey is cowboy camping. Could be interesting to see if we get any rain. Beautiful camp spot.
Some sriracha sauce in there.
Any eggs?
Yeah, probably eggs. Of course eggs.
Morning.
Beautiful day here in Death Hollow.
Joey, that looks really weird, that tent you have there. What kind of tent is that?
It's not homemade, but it's been homemade fixed.
I'm kind of impressed you were able to put that up.
Yeah, it started raining last night, 30 minutes after we went to bed. Thank you.
Here's a couple of bear tracks.
It's more than a couple bear tracks.
Slide down, I think. I'm reaching the point where I kind of know if it's going in. I don't want to go in yet. No! Here I go. The problem is, I can't tell how deep the water gets. See, that's almost going to be pretty deep.
How's it going, Joey?
Good.
You having fun?
Yeah.
This is awesome. Cold water, paddle through my little raft here.
Hey man.
What's up, man? Yeah, buddy.
It was too fun, Joey.
Oh.
That's where we came through. Thank you.
Yeah, we camped. We climbed right up here. We camped a couple years ago.
Yeah, that looks like a great camp up there.
But, I mean, I think the one we want to go for is nice. Going the wrong way, man.
I know, I'm just sitting here, circling, enjoying the pool. All right, I'm not going anywhere, so.
You're gonna have to start paddling.
I know.
What's up, buddy?
Hey, man, how's it going?
It's good.
You having fun?
Yeah.
This is awesome. Yep.
Look how high those walls are right there.
Because it's so slippery.
All this could go like 5 feet.
That's awesome. Good job.
Just waiting to fall and crush somebody blowing up their tube. Is that right above where you were standing for 10 minutes?
Yeah, it is.
just waiting for somebody to be stomping around on the ground over there, right below it. All right, dude.
Oh yeah, right before the choke's done. So this rock's not bad?
Yeah, it's good. Having a good day, Joey?
So far. Are you?
Yep. Wonderful.
Hey there, buddy.
I bet they eat frogs.
Yeah, probably. What are you waiting for?
How was that, Joey?
Not too bad.
That's a lot of fun. Oh man.
It was a great day. Great views. Kind of hot. I think we got baked in the sun. We kind of waited till late in the afternoon to be doing the hike. So it's hot, but it's awesome.
For the first time in over 4 hours, Jarl's pulled his camera out to take a shot.
Route. We're basically going to start off by getting into Muddy Creek and then going through some narrows. Pretty stoked to be doing this. We've been planning this trip for a while. Keeps falling apart. And finally the conditions are right. We got a really hot day today. It's supposed to get into the 90s. So a great day to be walking in the water to start. But might get hot at the end. So let's go see what happens. What do you think about this shoe? So what we have here is the rare appearance of the Norwegian explorer on camera, aka Jarl from Norway, aka the map guy, aka the stats guy, aka the secret weapon, aka Carl with a J.
We're approaching Yusa Canyon, you know.
Pretty cool, man.
Great day to be alive. Chimney Canyon. We're gonna go scout out a camp.
Joey, what do you got here?
I got a lot of food, but...
Show me some highlights here from your kitchen.
Oh, well, you can see we got a lot of avocados, which is probably one of the best foods for any human being to eat. Eggs, you can see that they handle themselves very well. So I'll eat eggs every night with avocado. This tonight we're actually gonna have some smoked sausage. Probably gonna give Jarl some of this because I can't eat it all. Got some shallots, a lot of jalapenos, cheese, butter, lemons. Yeah, this is overkill, but you gotta understand me and how I live, and it's hard for me to get nutrition. So when I get shorter hikes like this, my body's always craving this kind of food.
Do I spot bacon here?
Yeah, that's bacon. I forgot about that. That's some of it. I got all kinds of stuff. I actually got a Mountain House meal in there. What else we got? Sugar. Oh, yeah. Well, that's coffee. Keto coffee. Gonna be trying these things out. I got all kinds of food. I can pull. This is actually, these things right here are little couscous packets. I found these. There's a lot of different like flavors to them, and these are great for mixing with eggs, avocados. Oh, you know what else I got in here? Sriracha sauce.
Nice. What are those two you got some boxes of some
beers.
Couple of beers.
Bubble stash. I don't know. I got this in Colorado. Bubble stash has got my attention. It's an IPA. It's supposed to be good. And see, a bunch of tuna packets. So, some bars. There's all kinds of stuff in here, but that's pretty much the gist of it.
How to say that I envy you your kitchen here.
We're gonna eat good.
Here in the canyon.
Yeah. And so, like, all this food, even with all this heat, it's not going to go bad. And the cheese and butter kind of took a hit because I had them on top of the pack.
Here's an old mining spot close to the Hidden Splendor mine. So might be a part of that. Here's an old car, some bullet holes in it. All right, we found camp right here in this canyon. Tucked in between all those big walls here. Okay, it's 7 p.m. and we've decided it's better to be on the safe side and hike out. I think we got about 10 miles to do back to the car. And I think it's a pretty good trail, so we should be able to get out like maybe around 11 or midnight or something like that. But better safe than sorry. So the forks of Chimney Canyon has to wait for another time. We're on the pasture track. That should take us part of the ways back to the car, if not all. Beautiful light over Muddy Creek down here. Through the frogs.
All right, now I gotta find a way to climb up here. I've heard this is supposed to be a friction climb, so maybe just keep to the right, probably. Could be the smart thing. Over there. We'll try that.
This is kind of fun. Reached Silliman Lake. Pretty cool place.
And there's Mount Silliman. My camp. Pretty awesome campsite. It's a cold morning up here. God, I place here. Comes the sun finally. It's 8 a.m. now. Curious little guy here. Hey, buddy. What are you waiting for? Hey there. Hey, man. Did you smell some food? I bet he thought my marmot tent was a relative that he was gonna check out. Hey there. It's time to go, buddy. So here's Mount Silliman. Another small lake here. Last one before I start climbing. Real. Gonna head up right here. Amazing views. Climbing up to Mount Silliman to the summit. There it is. 100 yards, 200 yards. Hard to say. Let's go. All right, here we are. Ooh. Feet. So, looks like I'm the first one up here this year. At least the first one who signed the journal. Sweet. This is where I came from. Gonna do a panorama here. Looking north,
and south. Over here is Alta Peak, just in front of those clouds there, a little bit to the right, I think. We got the tableland over here. That's where I'm planning to go. But since my route is a little bit messed up, since I couldn't get down that chute there, it might take me a day longer or two to get there. So I'll have to play it by ear. Insane views here. That's Mount Whitney out there. Can barely see it, kind of sticking its head out from behind that other mountain there. Down here we have Twin Lakes. And we got Silliman Pass and Twin Peaks out there. But there's definitely some clouds or some fog coming in here. So maybe I should think about heading down and find my way around. Probably 200 yards away. I'm way zoomed in on the other side of the river. Beautiful. Finally at Twin Lakes. This is beautiful. Stunning. Thank you. I think I found camp here, overlooking this lake. Nice and peaceful here.
Well, look here, Twin Peaks decided to show up. Very cool. Nearly at Silliman Pass now. Here we are. Silliman Pass. And that's Mount Silliman that I was on the top of yesterday. Pretty cool. Mount Silliman. I left my pack to climb Twin Peaks, so here we are. All right. This is neat. That's Ranger Lake just below us. Looking north from Twin Peaks. Awesome. Look at this. That's a stunning sight. I've kind of reached the crux here. Now I gotta find out how to make my way past this area here. I reached an unnamed lake right below Mount Silliman. Crescent Lake. Beautiful. Ranger Lake and Mount Silliman. Day 4, and this is gonna be my last day, so I'm gonna head back to the car, which should be about 10 miles. Listen to all the birds. Saying goodbye to Ranger Lake.
Time to go, buddy.